The Philippine Central Bank says average headline inflation eased in the second quarter of the year. It declined to an average of 4.3% during the April to June period from 4.5% in the first 3 months of the year. The BSP says while inflation remained above government's 2-4% target range, food prices eased in the second quarter. It adds inflation will remain within target, even with elevated oil prices. The BSP also asserts monetary policy stance will need to remain accommodative for as long as necessary in order to ensure the recovery of the economy. The Philippines' three major telcos will begin implementing mobile number portability by September 30th. Mobile subscribers who want to switch network providers or change to either postpaid or prepaid services can retain their phone numbers. The process is free for all users with no limits to how many times they can switch between telcos. TCI, the firm set up by Globe, Smart, and Ditto, will oversee the process. The government and the private sector believe the Philippines has a good chance of becoming an e-commerce leader in Southeast Asia. But to achieve this, Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez told market leaders during Thursday's Digital Pilipinas launch that a whole-of-nation approach is needed. The use of e-commerce in the country has increased from 70% in 2019 to 80.2% in 2021 amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Online businesses involved in retail trade also went up significantly from below 2,000 in March last year to more than 88,000 by the end of 2020. The DTI projects an increase in e-commerce enterprises from 500,000 in 2020 to 1 million by 2022. Slow internet connection in the country, however, remains as one of the hindrances to this. Over in Europe, the central bank vows to keep interest rates at record lows for even longer. The European Central Bank says it will not hike borrowing costs until it sees inflation reaching its 2% target. Inflation has lagged the ECB's target most of the past decade, and the goal has slipped further from its grasp since the onset of the pandemic. The ECB expects inflation in the Eurozone to hit 1.9% this year before falling back to 1.5% in 2022.
The euro area economy is rebounding strongly, but the outlook continues to depend on the course of the pandemic and progress with vaccinations. The current rise in inflation is expected to be largely temporary. Underlying price pressures will likely increase gradually, although leaving inflation over the medium term still well below our target. Our policy measures, including our revised forward guidance, will help the economy shift to a solid recovery and ultimately bring our inflation to our 2% target.
The shift was prompted by the ECB's new strategy when it vowed to maintain an accommodative monetary policy stance and even let inflation edge above 2% because interest rates are near rock bottom. But the change in tone was not backed by all ECB policymakers.
We did not have unanimity, but we had an overwhelming majority about the calibration of the forward guidance on ECB interest rates. But that's what I had anticipated. And what matters most is the fact that directionally we were all on the same page and determined to revise the forward guidance as we did, but also to make sure that it is geared to implement our strategy.